Do I really want to do this? I haven't done like this, something like this in 7th grade. What if it doesn't feel the same? What if I'm making a mistake right now? Stop it. I want to and I have to. I already agreed to it. There's no turning back now. Why'd you park so far away? So we don't get caught, trust me. It's the number one thing to do when you're robbing something or doing something illegal. Fine, I'll trust you since you've been doing this longer than me. Okay. You take the knife, I'll take the gun. Let's go. All right. Let's go this way. All right. Look what we have here. Jacob Carter, I'm guessing you wanted to come back here. I'm gonna get ready to shoot her, okay? Okay, if she attacks you, I'll attack her. Deal. One down, a couple more to go. Do you know how many exact scientists are in this place? No, and I never thought of that. There could be billions in here. Yep, we'll just go, come on. Please let me out. I didn't do anything to you. Why are you doing something to me? Let me out. Before we do anything to you, we can't forget about the red collar that we forgot last time. What do you mean last time? I was never here. Oh, silly Grayson, we're not talking about you. Then who are you talking about? I'm so confused right now. Grayson, just trust me. I will never trust you, even if I had to. Perfect. What is this for? What are you gonna do to me? Oh, Grayson, stop whining. We're obviously gonna do something bad to you. You should already be familiar with that by now. What do you mean, familiar with that? I mean, you do bad stuff to people too, so you should know. Do you know how scared they were? Well, they were as scared as you right now, and this is gonna teach you never to do that stuff again. We will stop when you're good to go. But if you're never good, we're keeping you here forever. Let me go! Listen to me, Grayson. Do you know where he is? What are you talking about? Don't be so silly. You know who I'm talking about. The guy who's messed up, who always kills. The guy who almost killed the one you love, as you call it. Or as we say. Jacob Carter? I don't know where he is. You actually expect me to know where that guy is? I don't even want to know where that guy is. Grayson, don't lie to us. We know you know. I don't know, okay? No, please just let me go. We're not letting you go. We're doing something even worse than letting you go. And since you won't tell us, scientists, please go get the weapon. Yes, Dr. Martin. Jesse, I got it. Thank you. What is that? It's nothing. Hey guys, so you know, remember Jesse Martin? Well, I am actually gonna use this as Jesse Martin because, yeah, in the last part, so sorry for the little thing, whatever this is called, like talk thing, because I haven't made this episode in a while. And the last time I made it was probably a week ago because I was on vacation. So I'm sorry, guys. I will continue now. Oh, and yes, Jesse Martin is a boy. Ah, get this thing off of me. Ow. Oh my god. Dr. Martin? I think it's a good time to get out of here.
Let me out.
Please let me out.
The door's open. Let's go.
That's the guy who tried to kill me.
It is.
Let me go, please. I didn't do anything to you. Please.
We'll see about that. What are they doing to him?
I have no idea.
Kyle? Where are we?
Kyle, get up. Get up.
What?
What, Jacob? I can barely remember anything.
Let me get out.
It's very secure. I don't think we can.
Kyle, I'm not stupid.
What do they want from you?
Like, why do they capture you?
It's because they want to get revenge.
They want me to feel what I did to all the people I killed and hurt.
Oh. And do you think Ivy was mean?
Is that why you hurt her?
Why did you?
Ivy's not mean at all, by the way.
Kyle, we already had this conversation. I don't want to get more into it, please.
I said I don't want to hear her name right now. Please.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No, I didn't think she was mean. But I thought she was going to be mean, and since, well, she's part of the family.
Oh. Well, look who it is. Jesse?
Martin?
Yep. Oh, what a surprise, isn't it? Jacob Carter, what an honor to see you again.
Jesse, what are you doing here?
Well, since I got kicked out of the gang, I thought this would be a great job. Guess what? It is, because I get to hurt you, Jacob Carter.
Oh, and I heard that your gang fell apart after you kicked me out.
You needed me a lot.
You made a huge mistake, Jacob Carter. A huge mistake.
Shut up.
We were better without you anyway.
Well, if you're better than without me, then...
Where is your other gang members?
You would have probably escaped if you never had kicked me out.
You probably would have already left by now.
No, I don't think so. I think it would be much better.
Much better with you, but...
Guess what? You don't need me anymore, I guess.
You do need me, but I guess you don't think you do.
I'll see you in the morning, Jacob Carter. Kyle Carter.
No, wait, this can't be happening.
It seems so unreal. Maybe I shouldn't have done that to Jacob. I mean, I know that he kind of hurt me. But that doesn't mean I don't feel bad. Maybe I shouldn't have snapped like that. I think I should go for his house. I should definitely. He doesn't understand though. That was pretty bad. I mean, not as bad as him, but still pretty bad. Whenever he was 10 years old, she just stood there with her knife. Out ready to kill somebody. Get away! You know who should get away? Specifically out of this world? You. Get off of me, please. Police sirens. I need to hurry. All evidence lost. Police! What? Little girl. Did you see anybody holding a knife? Specifically, another little cat. Probably not you, but anybody. Well, maybe it's you. But did you see any little cats holding a knife?
No, ma'am. I'm sorry.
That's fine, little girl. You go on and play, or go home, okay? You should probably get inside. The killer's probably loose.
Okay, thank you, Mrs.
As a kid, Jacob killed over probably 100 people every month. Ivy only probably killed probably 5 people a month.
Yet they had similarities.
But yet, lifestyles different.
As Ivy got older, she realized what she was doing.
She realized it was wrong.
She began slamming the door on her parents, crying for help every night.
But then when she got older, she finally stopped. Her parents were out of her way when she turned 18. She was finally free from their horrors.
As a kid, Ivy got taught every single way to kill.
Since Ivy grew up with it, she thought it was normal.
Yet she wasn't normal. One little bit.
Ivy's parents were hiding a lot more than Ivy knew. Ivy's parents had killed Jacob Carter's parents.
After that, Ivy's parents vanished. They were never seen again.
God, oh my God, oh my God, I thought I lost Jacob for a second. Oh my God, I was gonna die, I was gonna die.
Okay, but anyway, Jacob looked everywhere for them, but never found them at all. As for Ivy's sister, she was always kept at their aunt's house. She always never knew why, but she did. She never knew that her sister had killed,
and yet her sister never told her.
She would be scared that she would turn her back on her and never talk again.
Ivy didn't want that, so she kept it a secret.
Whenever Kate tried to ask her parents why she was left at her aunt's house, her parents would just turn away and not answer.
When Ivy's mother would mysteriously vanish,
Kate would always be suspicious.
Kate never knew it was jail, though.
If she did know, then she would probably be scared.
Kate's dad was telling them that it was because of business trips.
Ivy kept her mouth shut, didn't say anything at all.
When their parents vanished, they both lived together.
When they were sleeping peacefully, Kate got taken away by the one and only Jacob Carter. She was beaten, yelled at, and much more you don't want to know.
When Kate was gone, Ivy sat there, crying in her bed, waiting for her to come back. She did. She was so happy. So happy.